Gabriella here, and joining us today, Teresa with the Museum of Riverside for another episode of Inside the Vault, and today, quite literally. So we have an object here that I'd love for you to kind of get into.
Yeah, so we are talking today about Rin Tin Tin. He was a famous dog in TV, film, and this hat was possibly worn by a child who was a really big fan of the TV series that ran in the 1950s, from 1954 to 1959, The Adventures of Rin Tin Tin.
Now, people might not be as big as fans as we are here in Riverside and might not know the history and why it is actually here in the museum. So
yeah.
Can you kind of walk us through
that? It's a long history. Rin Tin Tin, who appeared in this program from the 1950s, was actually Rin Tin Tin III. He was the descendant of the original Rin Tin Tin that lived in Riverside. Lee Duncan was his trainer, and he found this Rin Tin Tin in the fields of war-torn France and brought Rinty home. That was his nickname, Rinty. Brought him home and decided he would make a good movie star. So in the 1920s, he starred in several silent films. And then later in the 1950s is when we see Rin Tin Tin III starring in a television show.
Okay, so there were several different dogs that played this role of Rin Tin Tin, not the original sometimes, but I understand there's kind of a cute, quirky story with the third. I understand he was a little unruly on camera.
So Rin Tin Tin III, maybe not the movie star that his you know, grandfather, great-grandfather was. He did not show well on film, so he was relieved of some of his duties, though he got to play this role, and he brought many visitors to Riverside to see him, because so many people were a fan of this show, especially in the 50s.
Yeah, why do you think that was? Why do you think this was such a hit in that time?
That is a great question. There was a lot of reasons. I think the relationship between the boy Rusty was the character who would have worn this hat, and he's featured on this cap here with Rin Tin Tin. I think it's really the relationship between a boy and his dog. It really boils down to that really archetypical storyline. So they did just about everything together in the show, so he was a really important first dog or dog in the movies.
Definitely easy to love, for sure.
Absolutely. And as Rin Tin Tin, he's starring in these movies early on, and in the 50s, German Shepherds became really popular as pets in the as a result of Rin Tin Tin.
Yeah.
So he really was an ambassador for the breed as well.
How important is it to display these items here and keep them so sacred and protected?
Yeah, so because of this relation, the relationship of Rin Tin Tin to Riverside, these types of objects become our treasures. And we treasure every object, but certain things we take extra care. This has just gone through a process of conservation because there were some things on it that were a little unshapen here, and so we have conservators that we bring in for certain things, and this was stabilized the top was reshaped to how it may have looked when it was worn in the 1950s.
How does an item like this get selected for the vault and maybe not on public display?
Right now, as you may know, the museum is closed to the public, so all of our things, unfortunately, are off display. But we do rotate all of our objects, even if we were open to the public, so we don't want everything on display because that can also lead to damage and long-term light exposure, those sorts of things. So the hat being in here, tucked away usually inside a box and wrapped really nicely with all of our conservation materials, helps to keep it stabilized for many, many years to come.
So for anyone watching in the vault, is there anything else you'd like to share about Mr. Rin Tin Tin?
Oh, he was quite the charismatic dog, and from the first Rin Tin Tin all the way to today, these dogs are really special to people.
Absolutely. I don't think you have to be a dog lover or a Rusty fan to appreciate this story.
Absolutely.
Well, thank you, Teresa, for your time.
Thank
I look
you.
Forward to what we have next in the vault.